thank you to Kurt Bramich to give me the chance to give you a presentation. We know each other from the German Linux Tag, and I am the coordinator of the agency congress in the German Linux Tag, so I'm more from the view of the German administration and from the politicians, but this has to do something with Skola Linux or with Linux at all. And so, see it. And I also wanted to thank you. And I also wanted to say to you, it is very important that you remind this. It is only a critical review.
You could go to stand on the side.
Yeah, a critical, thank you very much. A critical review from the German point. Nothing with internationality, but only from the German point. But it's very important for our international guests to see what is reality in Germany and in German schools. And so it could be that you don't like my presentation, but don't bother me.
It's German anyway.
We discussed this with
I'm sorry.
First of all, that's my history. The coordination and advisory board of the German Federal Ministry of the Interior. Well, this is a ministry which is responsible for the IT in the whole administration of the federal administration. You know, in Germany we have a very complicated administration. At the top there is the federal administration with about 400 agencies. And then in the second level there is the administration of the countries, of the German countries, federal countries. They also have a government and a prime minister and ministries, and in these ministries there are the responsibilities for the schools, not on the top. That is a different between other countries. I think in France the Ministry of Education is also responsible for schools, and there are only the which is there's a I think prefect also it's called. Yes, but it's not, you cannot make a view from this and this, and this is very totally different in all of Europe. Germany is a federal country, and so we have these levels in the administration, and the responsibility is in the middle level, this for the schools, the countries, the government of the countries are responsible. So the coordination and advisory board is on the top level, and there are working parties in which they are sitting together. And they are responsible for all the things that in the administration, the use of the information technology is optimized, and the use is very economically in the agencies. And also they have to advise all the IT people in the agency. So the Coordination Advisory Board has, well, has not the room to say do it like this or do it like this. They only can put guidelines, just what is good to do. And one of these guidelines was this here. It is a very, let me say, a very successful product of this administration. It was the migration guideline, which was also put in other languages now. It is, I think, in English, in Polish, in Vietnamese, and so on. And
do you remember the download 400 pages in Oslo? This was this paper.
Yeah, this was this paper. This was this report. And very interesting, in the first report, they detailed described how to exchange. That's not from me, that's from the Cola people. But it's very nice. Exchange. This is written totally in this report on 419 pages in the first version. So, and you can imagine who is fighting against it. Well, before this, there was the German KST letter. It's an informational media for the administration. It's spread out to the administration. It's normally only for the administration. But this letter, which I wrote, was the promoting of the use of open source software in the federal administration. And this was in the year 2000, totally new. So now, for this presentation, I just thought about the title. And my first title was Linux on Desktops. But this was not the right title, and then I saw it again, and the second title was Why is there no Linux on Desktops? Oh. Well, and see this asterisk here, it's exclusively seen from the German view. And if you look in Germany around, in administrations, in school and so on, well, you will find a little islands with Linux. But mostly, there's no Linux on the desktop. Why? Well, we have some laws of how German schools and German teachers are working. Excuse me. Well, one is, we always did it like this. And we'll never do it in another way. The second is, every Tom, Dick, and Harry could make his demands. And the third is, we have never done this before, and so we don't do it now. These are rules like German administration and like German, the schools are part of the administration, the German schools and teachers are thinking. It's horrible, but this is reality. So we have a problem from the mentality of the people and of the teachers. The man likes having to know this. That's an experience you all have. And therefore the user's question is, why Linux? And why it's called Linux? Well, these are the answers. I don't need it. Another thing is, I have XP at home and I don't like to learn again to the use of computers. Does it run under XP? These are pupils. Pupils asking me, does it run under XP? Which games are available? And last but not least, that's totally crazy. At home, I don't have to pay for Windows. It is free. Also for schools, it is free. You know, all that's the vibe. So, what we tried in the public administration in our agency was we set up two identical desktops. We make it as equal as possible, so we include all of the pictures from Windows on the Linux desktop and test it with the users. It was very funny. Dr. Mesk is from Creative and Mr. Richard know this. They are sitting beside the projects and laughing. So this is a desktop you know. No, it's on Linux, can't be. And this is the equivalent disk. What you not know?
Well, it's top there. You can see the difference.
Well, if you look.
Yeah, very.
Yeah, this one, this I can change back to the other one, which is more sympathetical. Yeah. This is a little different.
It is.
Yes. Well, what did the users? Most of the deciders didn't take part of the test. Functions which are identical on both systems are very better if the system was XP. And new functions compared to Office 97 are very better if the system was XP. It's funny. And the same situation is in German schools. What are the reasons for this evolution? Well, we as developers here are only viewing from the technical point, and I wanted to show you that there is a social point of view. And for the children, there's no advantage for them to use this or this system. Security and economy are not very important for children, but for the teachers or for the administrators of the systems, not for the children. The children have problems with games and edu software. In Germany, there are some smaller companies developing edu software, and this edu software is presented on exhibitions in Germany to the teachers, and the teachers are going to school and say to the parents of the children, well, we have a very nice CD, we found it on an edu exhibition. And on this CD, there are programs that will help your children to learn better German, better mathematics, better every other thing you could learn at school. You only have to buy it. It just costs €30. And if we get 150 bought, then we get a license for the school, isn't it good? Yes, and all the parents buy the software, and you know, it's only running under another operating system. Well, so we have a very big problem with the EDU software. And another thing is, if anything goes wrong, it directly suffers. So there's no motivation for the schools to move. Deciders do what the children and the publishing houses want. And deciders are very conservative, and they are not experienced with free or liberal open source software. Well, make a little step back and excuse for this slide here. Who of you know the European Action Plan 2002 or has ever heard about this? Please sign up. Yes. The French colleagues, it's nice. But it was a very big action plan. At this time, Erkki Liikanen, who was a Finnish man, was European Commissioner, and he was responsible for the European society. And he set up this action plan to make a little competition between states of Europe. And there are three main tasks. And one objective was that he wanted to invest in people and skills to bring Europe's youth into the digital age. And one task, and this is the original sentence of this action plan, was that it should be for teachers, pupils, and parents access to digitized cultural heritage, multilingual media, learning metrics, European open source software initiative. But in the next action plan, which was started in 2005, there was nothing from that, because the European Commission said, well, all the goals are fulfilled. And I don't see it that they are fulfilled. What is the German reality in 2004? Who from you knows this paper in Germany, from the German colleagues? Anybody? Yeah. Then you know the values which are in this paper. It is a study how the environment in the schools of Germany is different. How many Windows users are there, how many Linux systems, and so on. And if you see this here, these are the values from the years. Let's see, Windows in German schools. This is funny, 100% and then 99%. this is a sum of all schools, and this is Linux. And the very funny thing is, for this study, 14% Linux in schools and 99% Windows. I don't know how they got these numbers.
Well, it's possible that they use both.
Yeah.
Good. Yeah. Many do.
Many do, that's right.
And the reason is very simple. They have an obligation in education to let people get to know different systems.
Yeah.
When they get into real life work, you know, know if you're going to drive a BMW to the work, or Mercedes-Benz, or call in a
That's right.
You know, you have to have knowledge about shooting.
Yeah, yeah. That's totally right what you said, and it's this is a cumulated sum, I say. And there's no difference because we have a different schools in Germany. You know, we have the basic schools, we have the so-called colleges or so. Yes, and they are put all together in these values here. But it's interesting on this here. Well, another fact also from this study is this here. If you see these values, you have e-learning software, you have multimedia directories, whatever this means. I've heard that some of the pupils are only using one electronic directory, and if the teacher has a special question, they only find the thing, the object, print it out and bring it to the teacher, and if it's the right operating system, he says, okay. Programming languages, multimedia, and now see the reality in Germany. These are all things you know about. Reality is this here. E-learning software in Germany is licensed by publishing house or school books. Totally licensed. No chance. Multimedia directories. Well, there's one big and some small ones, but they're also licensed and published by school laws. On this thing here, who has ever heard, I think from the teachers, about the project Antolin? Antolin. Well, it's like this. There are some books and there are questions what the contents of the book. And children's got an internet access to this web application, and then they can answer the questions, like a quiz. And then the teachers must pay for this. They have to pay a license, and they can administrate the pupil accounts. And if the pupil is very good, he can answer many questions. If he is not so good, okay. Well, but this is digital separation of the society. What is if the pupil has no internet access? Well, under tools licensed by software companies, program languages also licensed by software companies, and also this here cremating multimedia applications also licensed. Well, but these are the original data taken from the report, which is official. You can download it from the internet page of the ministry, see? But we have alternatives. There are alternatives for e-learning software. This is, for example, Open Web School, but I think it's not maintained now in the moment. One is G-Comprise, which you can set up in kindergartens and in basic schools, very fun. Oh, this one, OpenOffice, you can use it everywhere. Multimedia, well, we have a very famous application, therefore it's Wikipedia. And, well, I don't know why teachers on the world do not connect together and make a fork in Wikipedia for pupils. I think there's a project going ahead, but I have something heard about it, but never read about it. But this is a very good solution for all the school books. On the tools, everything you want you have in the free software array, programming languages, no limit, and also creating multimedia applications. Look at Hollywood. On the last GUADEC developer conference, which was located in Stuttgart, there was a presentation from DreamWorks. Anybody who knows DreamWorks? Yes.
I have an idea.
Yeah. Well, the last famous film was Madagascar. Totally made with Linux. Totally. But what has all this to do with us here? Well, if you want to promote Scholar Linux, see it widely from the pupils and teachers' view. We are more engineers and technicians, and we see it only from the technical view. But we must include the teachers and we must include the pupils in our view. Another thing is, the technical concepts of Skoda Linux are excellent, but not important for the users. And also, you have to bring up a modern and actual GUI, like KDE 3.4.
Why?
Why? Well, if you want to play in this market, in the market where big companies go in and sell notebooks to pupils for 20 euros in the month, then you are playing against XP. And if your GUI is lower than XP, you are against the desk of the...
Sorry, you just showed before with your own tests that it doesn't matter.
No, this was a... Pardon, this was a test. This test started in a public administration, not in a school.
So you say that the same test would show something different. If only you had KDE 3.4, then the test would show different.
No, pardon. This test has been done in a public administration. And in a public administration, it doesn't matter, because they are only doing work on documents, sometimes on tables, and most work with email and surfing in the internet. That is the work which a civil servant does in the public administration. But in school, the pupils which are sitting in school, they have their own computer. I am living in a town. And in this town, I make a little computer working party for the pupils. And the pupils which are coming to me all have a personal computer by their own. And they all are using XP, and so they are know how to use XP. They don't have the old computers from their parents. They have the newest machine because they wanted to play the games.
Just to stick to your argument that it is important to have KDE 3.4 instead of 3.3 or 3.2 or whatever.
Yeah.
This you're telling me has nothing to do with 3.4 contract or 3.3. It has to do with stick to Windows because they want all the games. It has nothing to do with what kind of KDE. Sorry.
But I think from the concept, from the graphical concept and so on, the KDE 3.4 is more modern than the other one. And you could put in easier games and so on. And you could model the GUI more to XP. And so for the pupils there is no difference between using. They also have in their head, I don't know why, they have in their head, well, it's very... I don't want to get more experience with the computer. I wanted to play with the computer. You see? Normally they don't see the graphical user interface, and then you are right. But the first thing they see on a computer is Windows and is XP. That's a problem.
But
yeah.
We have some examples in Norway that we have downgraded UI to, for instance, ISVN, because it have a XP where you look alike the same colors and
yeah.
Blah blah. And some ICT managers just do that because they think they get in less troubles. We also have investigation done by what do you call it? Unbiased studies, a lot of studies. It's not
yeah.
One, it's 4 or 5. And the report from there is that the teachers are very happy that the pupils will get all the games because they can concentrate on the education. The other thing is that the big discussion is about open office proprietary formats that people have Windows Home to work home and don't can interchange, so we have to fix that. You know? So like the thing we does is to take open office 2.0 and yes. Save it in Microsoft Office document, I'm
yeah.
Sorry to say. So, and the pupils really say that Linux are as good as Windows XP, it's no different. It's probably more choosable in a kind of, you have freedom.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That real life experience when people said use this is that they don't care.
It's not a discussion of degree. This is a discussion of opinion. And to discuss opinion, as you told when you started your lecture there, was that you're supposed to tell some opinions, and that's okay.
Yeah.
So continue, tell opinions.
Yeah, you are totally right. I agree with you, but see, it's only critical of you.
That's
so it would motivate you to
do something better.
Yeah. And the other thing, I understand right, they downgraded it. That they have no more games to concentrate on education. That's right. But this is an argument for the high school and the colleges, I think, in Germany. But we have a new philosophy now in the country of North Rhine-Westphalia. We are living here, and we are here in this country. And this philosophy is that they have no philosophy for the basic schools. Normally, the basic schools are for children from 6 and up to 10 years. And normally the school ends at 12 o'clock or at 13 o'clock, and then the pupils go to home, get their meal, make their homework, and so on. Sometimes they go to an extension of the kindergarten, and there's someone who looks at the children and the homework. The new way is to integrate this work in the school. And so you have two things to do with the computers. In the morning, you have to learn with the computers, that's right. But in the afternoon, when the homework is done, the pupil can play with the computers, and then you have to be modern.
And that's why we made Snowflix with all the games.
Yeah, that's right.
So Norway also have an answer on that. And the biggest problem, and I have to say this, is that the people, parents, don't put the CD into the computer.
Yeah.
And my father, that too, he said, the biggest problem is that you have to think to put your hand in the CD into the computer. And the only thing you have to do is to do that. Then you have a successful game.
I think another problem is that they don't know what is booting from the CD.
That's
the same in German.
That's a big problem, I agree.
Okay.
But you have to continue.
Okay. Well, now a little bit from my private experience. I wanted to set up a terminal-based server and a network in a basic school and a kindergarten. I tried it with school and Linux. Technical and worked fine. But for the kindergarten, there were not the right programs. Because the small child liked to play, and they wanted things like Supertux and such. The other problem in the basic school for me was there was an Arctur server. Arctur is also a German Linux project which was set up by Heise Verlag, and it's called the Open Database Server, I think, ODS system, and the product is Arctur. Well, it is maintained now very good, and it is a Linux system. It's not a terminal server, it's only a Linux system with a Samba server combined, and an internet firewall, and a Squid server, and a Squid guard. And so it's configured totally good, and you only have to say, well, I want to have internet connection, and the school has internet connection, and also can switch it down. That's a very nice thing. But it's not spread wide in Germany. It's very good maintained. Number two was, well, then, if I didn't get the right system, I had to build it by myself. I set up a Debian system, installing the normal Linux terminal server, and bringing the games on the machines by hand. And this is a list, a small list of games which people like. It's SuperTux, it's Tux Type 2 to learn the key typing, or Rocks and Diamonds, and so on and so on. Yes, I know, there are licensing problems. Rocks and Diamonds is not part of the Debian project, and so on. But I wanted to find a solution which works for my problem. See. Well, most problems I found were problems with multimedia games. Yes, that's no problem. These are in the following environment. There was one big server, it was a machine like this here. And there are thin clients, and a network which was based on a small switch for 19 euros, a very small switch, 8 ports or so. And in this network, I had some problems with multimedia sound, and so SuperTux ran very fast, but the sound came too late. Well, why aren't the games important? This is my experience now. The games are important because the children like to play. In the afternoon when the homework is done, they wanted to play with the computer. They are doing it at home. Also, the basic change, basic schools in North Rhine-Westphalia are changing their philosophy. They are changing into a full-time school, and so the children of the school are there in the afternoon. And the other thing is, when they have finished their homework, they wanted to play. Well, we discussed this before. Well, and 90% of the children in my computer working party, they have experience with the wrong operating system. They all have the so-called Aldi computer. Aldi is a big supermarket in Germany. Normally they are buying, they are selling food, but sometimes they are selling computers, and they are very cheap. Well, thank you very much for your attention, and if you have any questions and answers, I'm here.
One comment about the thin client, because it doesn't really support games, that's the truth. So that's because the technology is mostly used by older computers, reused computers. But now, as you showed us, they have new computers with more CPU,
no.
Graphical card. So in Norway, buy a lot of new, almost new computers with 800 megahertz processor.
No, this was only the start.
Well, that was a server, okay.
Only the server.
But even if you have thin clients then with less power, computer power, it's the people. So you have to turn the sound down because it's squeaky. You have to turn the delay because it's... So when you have a big server, it's really not fitted to transport graphics. So the solution to that in school is to keep down the maintenance cost, is to use half thick clients to solve that. And you can run your games locally with local hardware. Yeah. So that's one step in the right direction. And as you said, it's true. When the kids get home, they want to have the funnier games. That's totally true. And we get also that kind of questions in Norway when we are. I'm around traveling, but fortunately we have this Netflix initiative from the government, and they tell about it, and it's more like a consumer knowledge about this. We also have one more thing that you have a larger software industry in education, making Microsoft only software. In Norway, every year they get broke, so somebody has to start something new. So you don't have a strong software industry in schools, and they who have them deliver the things to the web browser because they can keep down the cost of distributing the software. So these also are changing the landscape a bit. It's we don't have so much showstoppers anymore.
Yeah.
So that's a difference.
Yeah. Thank you. This was very interesting because there are many differences in the European countries, and therefore it's for me very interesting to get input from you. In Germany we have the situation, there are traditional school book publishing houses and they are licensing all. It's a problem for the teachers to make a copy from a page of the book because they are breaking the license. See? Any other questions or remarks?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you for your audience.